就是能证明自己价值的地方。
But it's TPA coming out on top. Have they got the damage they damn well have? It is going to be an ace.
Bir League of Legends oyuncusunun en büyük hayali dünya şampiyonasını oynamaktır.
I think Worlds is a good opportunity to show how good of a player you really are.
It's Team Solo Mid coming out with the victory.
딱히 압박감은 없고 저희 팀이 제일 잘하는 것 같아요.
Pentakill! A complete shutout coming in for Samsung White.
也是一个展示自己队伍风格的机会，然后。
They just surprised AHQ by showing up behind them and start the party.
League of Legends World Championship. Our live coverage continues from the National Taiwan University Sports Center as 8 teams from around the world battle for a shot at the Summoner's Cup. Moments ago, Samsung White were busy preparing in their ready room before they take to the stage to face off against Turkey's Dark Passage, who were doing just the same. My name is Trevor Quickshot Henry, and joining me to lend their League of Legends knowledge to our special Worlds Analyst Desk are Evil Geniuses Mitch Crepo Forceballs. Welcoming to the desk, Counterlogic Gaming's Doublelift, Peter Double of Ping, and of course, on game netcaster, Christopher Monte Cristo Michaels. And at the end of the table, David Freak Turley from the North American LCS. Guys, before we head into today's matches, let's take a look back at some of the highlights from yesterday when we hit the halfway mark, starting with, I think, the obvious stories of Group A. Both Samsung White and Edward Gaming, far and away the favorites, the David and Goliath group. They are definitely close to punching their tickets. Monte, Samsung White, are they living up to what you expected?
Well, you can't live up to the hype more than you can a perfect game where your enemies take zero kills, zero towers, zero dragons. It was incredibly methodical, fast-paced. They controlled the enemy buffs from the get-go. It was a very, very impressive game. And we've seen their caliber of play improve, and we're probably going to see a similar game here up first.
Yeah, it definitely looks to be the case. And of course, the other group, which is a little more contested in Group B, Taipei Assassins and TSM, both coming out and surprising a little bit. TPA not really living up to quite what we were expecting coming into the tournament.
Yeah, I was super disappointed because I had predicted TPA to do well against TSM. I thought it would be a close game, but really TSM turned that game into a stomp pretty quickly. I mean, mid lane and jungle 2v2 killed them. The same time, Dyrus killed top lane 1v1, and TSM's bottom lane killed their bottom lane 2v2. It was like a 13-minute ace across the map with no team play. It was just all of their lanes getting mechanically outplayed.
And is TSM impressing you considering the other two games that they've played? You know, one win, one loss?
Yeah, definitely. I think TSM plays a faster game than I had expected, and they learned a lot from Korea. Mechanically, I think they're the same, but strategically and in terms of just like how confident they are coming in, I wasn't expecting that.
And I want to talk about SK a little bit as well. They did look incredibly shaky in their very first game, but they've actually improved significantly since. And now they're at full power with Sven Skaren as well. So SK, as well as TP, I think, can make a run, and they're definitely still in the playoffs.
Yeah, we'll have to see how they perform today. Yesterday, of course, we did have a little other fun off-air where, Krepo, you actually spent some time with Imagine Dragons, playing some games with them, streaming with them. How was that despite costing you sleep?
Yeah, when initially the news came out that they made the single for Worlds for the team song, I was like, yeah, do they even play League? And apparently they do. They play a lot of League of Legends apparently on tour, and I play with them, and they were actually pretty good at the
How
game.
How good? Come on.
I was actually a tired Krepo. Actually ended up killing them, getting them killed more than they got me killed. But it was really fun. They were really cool guys. There was no celebrity status. They were very humble. It was so much fun to play with them, and they were enjoying Twitch chat. So I got to explain them what Kappa was and Kipo, and but I left the dongers and stuff out.
Well, I'm glad you had some fun with them. Yeah. All right, since these matches are being played on the world stage, that does, of course, lead to some world-class plays. So here are three of the top moments from yesterday that you guys highlighted as hashtag world's big plays. First up comes from the Starhorn Royal Club versus SK match, where at 227 Gaming tweets, Insec, Undertower, Flash, Kick, can you ask for more? Here's your number three world's biggest play.
Whoa! Well, the zillion ultimates on him, but
can he leap away?
You were talking about extraction.
That's the aggression that Starhorn Royal Club have been looking for, and it was all once again. The intake kick, it finally worked. Big problems for SK Gaming.
The beautiful thing there about the Lee Sin kick is not only does he get behind them flash kicks, but the Yasuo ult gets broke at the end of the animation of the kick. Yeah. Sometimes Yasuos will just be spamming R and immediately go up, but no, they wait for him fully kicked out of tower at the max range. He'll get knock up extended even more. It's just beautiful CC chain, and sometimes you don't really like admire the real beauty in that. Sometimes Lee Sin's have to kick and Yasuo has to follow up immediately, but this time the best choice was waiting as long as you could, and yeah, perfect.
Yeah, and what was so good about it as well was that it allowed his team to kill the Kha'Zix while outside of turret range.
Exactly.
And once he revived the leap, still couldn't get him to safety. So there is a real reason to wait as well.
Yeah, it worked out in their favor. Next up is from the Taipei Assassins versus SK Gaming match, which featured that mid-game inhibitor feint into the Baron. From at the working... he tweets, yeah, I don't know, the rotations from TPA. Burla. What a move. Here's your number two big play.
And SK actually starting off the Baron, doing about half of the health bar, haven't finished that one off, and TPA have not only done the damage to the big tank, they've managed to actually stop them doing the Baron. They're going straight on mid.
So this is a completely different phrase for TPA. A decisive move when their backs are against the wall. Baron's going down with this level 18 Tristana. They force it. They engage on the Mundo, pull them off of Baron, and now they've run SK all over the map, shoving mid and switching over to Baron. Teleport the other trap.
This is really risky. They've got to take that Baron down very fast there, and they are doing the damage to it. The TPA are going to get it. They've taken the Baron, and SK are just too slow to the party.
If ever there was a rotation to throw to the king of rotations, I think that's it.
It was a really good rotation. Just that feint down the mid lane. Of course, if they lose the inhibitor, then they lose the Baron as well. So they just kind of fake him out, go for the Baron anyway, and then they're able to push into the open inhib. And Ryze and Kha'Zix, they're going to burn it down real fast at that point in the game.
So, Monty, what's the counterplay here?
Yeah, all right, let's move on. All right, your biggest play comes from the Samsung White Dark Passage game, where we did see that pentakill. And for that, we go to @Chunami. He tweets, that was impressive. Let's roll the penta.
Oh, man, they are still going for this fight. A little bit of brush control is going to be good for this one. Double kill coming in for Imp. He keeps
the
shots coming. The triple kill for Imp, looking for the Quadra.
Where is he?
And they are going to get it. The penta kill to come in for Imp. Penta kill!
Double, if you got to talk to me about that one.
Well, to be honest, they were 16k gold ahead at 23 minutes. So there wasn't a lot of mechanics going on there. But I can't attribute the mental game. I hate you. it's really great to get a pentakill. Even if you're, you know, the clear victor of the game or whatever, and you're playing against an underdog, if you get a pentakill, you're just going to feel really confident throughout the tournament. You're going to feel like, wow, I can do this. And then anytime you see a play that you can make throughout the tournament, you're going to be able to do it instantly because you just have that mental game.
Now, talk to me about the other AD carries. It's the first time we've got you on the desk for Worlds. What's your take on groups A and B, and how the AD carry play has either impressed or disappointed you?
Probably the biggest disappointment was Name, because I didn't expect him to lose 2v2 so hard to Imp and Mata. I mean, yeah, he might be slightly weaker in lane, but they got 2v2 killed, I think twice. So that's just really disappointing to me, and it just shows how far ahead Samsung White is, just in terms of their bottom lane 2v2 play.
Well, we'll have to see if they can keep that up. All right, sometimes avoiding what could have turned into a world's big play against your team and escaping with your hide intact can actually be just as important as that flashy string of kills. So this is where we highlight and salute the players who have narrowly avoided the jaws of death in a play we called Them Jukes. From EDG versus AHQ, this is a great dodge of the spear.
And really the big thing about this is that he's got such a little window to do this, but right here spots it, turns around just in time. And thankfully in the Nidalee rework, the width of the spear got reduced, otherwise he would have typically gotten hit
there. If he got hit there, that would have tilted the matchup really hard.
Yeah.
Well, same game. This is the invisible Name. What do you think of the ward placement there, Crepo?
Yeah, very optimistic. I would probably place it in the brush. But then again, I'm not my world, so.
Once he saw he was gone, he should have just hooked through the brush anyway and be like, oh, we went this direction and just tried for random mode.
Yeah. Alright, so this is from TSM vs TPA. It's a trio of Jukes. Twins, Dyrus, and Bjergsen. Dodge, dip, duck, dive, and I guess dodge. But it doesn't help Dyrus.
Because he dies.
Yeah.
Goodbye,
but it's not a bad try, though, to be fair.
It looked cool.
Yeah.
He had fire and everything.
I mean, look at that. He dodged the Zenith Blade as well. Dodges the Rango, you know?
At least he gives the kill to Leona. It's actually a little bit useful that way.
Exactly, exactly. All right, so almost got away. Gyrone, not lucky enough in that attempt. There will be plenty of opportunities for both big plays and Jukes today because we do have six more matches lined up. The action will start with Samsung White facing Dark Passage in a rematch. And the day will conclude with SK Gaming facing the Taipei Assassins once again. For the complete schedule, head over to lolesports.com where you can vote on the teams that you think will win each of today's matches. While you're there, you'll also find features, articles, stats, VODs of past matches, and much more to keep yourself informed throughout the entire World Championship. We'd also like to keep you to keep us informed, so we're going to head over to Twitter and tell us who has been the most outstanding player in the Taipei group stage and why. Freak, who's it for you?
It's got to be Mata. WFU talked about the fact that Name got, you know, 2v2 killed repeatedly in lane. That is all Mata. He is an incredible, incredible player, and I can't do anything but fanboy over how good he is.
Double lift, any reply? Who's your pick?
Probably runner-up would be FCZF, because when I feel EDG makes those game-winning plays, FCZF is always the one to initiate it, or set up the vision, or just, he does everything. He is the playmaker for that team, in my opinion. I think Klulev has been slacking a little bit. FCZF is always the one to make those game-winning plays, which I think you should watch out for.
Well, we will get chances to do so. All right, we want to hear what your answers are, so send them to us at LOL Esports along with that hashtag Worlds, and we'll share some of our favorites on air later in the day. Guys, we are going to a short break, and as we head out, it's going to be a quick look at our hard-working production staff who's busy putting the show together. So thank you for making us look good. We will be back for the first game of the day as Samsung White and Dark Passage take to the Rift. So stay with us. The 2014 World Championship continues right after this.